Hi friends, in this tutorial I am going to show you how to perform string reverse using different types of methods in Java. So now I am going to show you one by one using different methods how to implement reverse a string in Java. So now I am going to create one new Java class. I'll give class name is string reverse, and I'm choosing main method. First I'm going to implement using swap functionality. I'm using one temporary variable how to swap string in reverse order. For suppose I'll give any name, it will display in reverse order. First, I am going to create one method. In that method, I am going to write logic how to implement reverse string using swap functionality. So, public static methods. I am taking all static methods. So, if I create a static method, I no need to create any object. Directly, I will call from class name. The name is reverse. So return type string reverse mode using swap. So one name I'll pass. So now I'm going to write logic. As of now I'll return none. First I'm going to check if name is coming null or name equal to coming empty or something. Is empty. So I am written act as name, or if you want you can write null also, no problem. So otherwise char array. So now I am enter one string. That string I need to split one letter. So for suppose I am passing lowercase l o k s, like that I need to split each letter. So that's why I am writing char array. So characters. So in string you have one method, you need to split word into single letter. That method is two char array. After that I am taking one variable, that is I equal to 0 and int j equal to character dot length. I will take two characters dot length minus 1. So index will start at 0, that's why length minus 1 I am doing, because of I need to avoid array index out of bound exception. So that's why I am writing character.length minus 1. So after that I will take one while loop. Here I am checking one condition. I always less than j. That time only you need to write one functionality here. So I am going to take one more method, that is a swap. In that swap I am passing my characters array comma I comma j parameters I'm passing. So now I'm going to create this method. So in this method now I'm going to write original logic out swap functionality using temp variable. So now I'm going to take one char. I'll take temp variable. In that I'm going to write characters dot I. Next I am going to swap the same thing, characters dot I equal to characters dot of j. So now again I am swapping characters of j equal to temp. So this is the logic. This logic, it will swap based on index, it will change. The first index, whatever is coming, I equal 0 is coming for suppose I, 0. So I whatever character is there, that will display here. After that, I need to change to J character. After J, change to temp variable. Like this, it will swap. So after that, I need to write here. Now I am going to increase I and I decrease J. So finally, I am going to return new string of characters. So now I am going to test this method. If I pass any word, it will reverse or not. So now I am going to implement directly sys.out. I am going to write call direct dot method reverse word using swap. I am passing my name Lokesh. So now I am going to run. Check LOKS, it reverse, it will come. I given Lokesh, it will given LOKSH. Some people sometimes they asking is the given string is a palindrome or not. So that time what we are doing exactly, we are mention actual word Lokesh. Reversal word equal to, we are passing that actual word here. So you need to check that condition. See, directly I'll check actual word dot equals ignore case of reverse word. If it is written true, so actual is if it is that return is the true, that is the palindrome. Otherwise, it is not palindrome. So now I am passing Lokesh. Check that is written false because of Lokesh reverse again, it will not come Lokesh. So for suppose if I give madam, so if you read from left to right and right to left also, it will come as always madam. So now you check, it will return as a true. So some people if you ask is a palindrome, given string is a palindrome or not, you need to use this method. So currently we are concentrating only how to reverse a string using different types, different methods or predefined methods or user how user defined methods how need to implement, include using how implements string reverse using streams also. I am going to show you. So now I am going to take one more method. I'll remove this one. Was actual word. Next I am going to write one more method. In this method I am going to use if use for loop conditions, for loops. So how to reverse a string using general for loop. Now I am going to write public static string reverse word. So same thing, string generally many people using this functionality. So same thing, I am going to split one character. So name dot two char array. Now I am taking one string reverse word. First I will take empty. After that I am going to write one for loop. first I will write I equal to, first I need to check characters dot length minus 1. I already explained why I am taking minus 1. I need to avoid the out of bound exception. That purpose I am using minus 1. So because of length is given always length of the word, length of the characters, and but index is starting from 0. So finally I minus minus. Now reverse word equal to reverse word plus characters of or I. So final return that reverse word. Now I am going to test this method. Same way I will take, just I'll change method name reverse word. Set. So I'll write here method name. Here also I will change. So anyhow, first method I am eligible, that's why I put comment. I put on comment. Now I am going to run. So madam is anyway, it will come written madam also. I will enter my name. Check this one also is coming reverse. So if you want, you can execute first one also. Check both are is coming. Now third one I am going to show you how to use streams reverse string. So in that streams I am using predefined method. So if I don't want to use any user defined function implementation, I need to use Java predefined implementation for the reverse. So in string there is no reverse method, but in string buffer there is a method that is the reverse. So if you use the string buffer reverse method, you can easily reverse a string. Whatever string you given, that is automatically it will reverse. So but if you pass string, you need to convert the string into string buffer. So before that, before I am using string, I am going to write one method. In that method I am going to show you how to use predefined string buffer remove method, reverse method. I am going to write this. So I am going to write logic. Public static string free method. So here I am passing string name. So now I am going to reverse a string using string buffer. String reverse word new string buffer. So now name dot reverse dot to string. Check, this is a single line. Single line you can write reverse a given word. Return reverse word. Now I am going to test this method. Free method actual word. Check. Okay. Next I am going to write one method using streams. How to reverse a string. So now am going to write one more method, public static string reverse word using stream. So directly I'll write return stream is the util package stream dot off stream dot off name dot map I'm doing map now I'm taking word what exactly word after that I'm using string buffer. If you want you can use user defined function also inside that map. So now I'm using string buffer dot reverse dot collect, so collectors dot I'm using joining I'll give empty spaces. So this is also single line. The stream space is coming in 1.8. in main streams usability of the streams is you need to Java also supporting to the functional methods, so like just like Python like that. So streams is a different concept. If any users want, please put in comments. I will create full streams, how it will work, what are the methods is there. I will create one separate video for that one. If you are interested, please comment in comment box. Now I am going to test this method. Actual word. Check this one also coming locals. So sometimes people in interviewers asking reverse a string using recursion methods. So you need to recursion means you need to call that method until satisfy that method. So for suppose I'll give one string or some conditions, up to satisfy that condition, up to that time internal call that same method again is calling as a recurrent. So now I'm going to write reverse a string using recursion. So now I'm going to write one method, public static string reverse word using recursion string name. So now I am going to write same condition. If you want I can take this one. If empty is coming, need to write this method, same functionality. I'm going to avoid null pointer exception. So now I'm going to write method return. Check I'm calling same method again. So reverse word recursion. I'm passing parameter name dot substring 1 plus name dot substring name dot not substring plus dot caret 0. So here you need to call this method after I'm adding the character of 0 whatever is coming. So like this. So this is the one of the most important question commonly asking in interview. Sometimes maybe they'll ask experience. Most of the professors, they will ask this question. And whoever trying job for below 1 year or 2 years, sometimes in experienced persons also may ask this question. So I guess this is helpful for you. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel and like my video and share to some other people. If you want more videos, please put in comments what you want. If any program you require, please put in comment box. I will create for you that video. Thanks for watching. Sign off. Bye bye.